We looked in the scientific literature, and it turns out that there are many, many years of study of how both people and animals respond to what we psychologists call reward. There's a part of the brain known as the reward system. It's a fairly complicated circuit that becomes active when you receive these kinds of stimuli. And it used to be thought that this reward system was only engaged when there was something really biologically significant. So the question always comes up as to why it is that this sort of meaningless stimulus that we call music, patterns of sounds that are unfolding in time, why would it be the case that they engage this reward system? Part of what we think is going on is that the brain is basically a prediction engine. In other words, the brain is receiving all kinds of information from the environment, and it's trying to make sense of what's going on, and it's trying to predict what's going to happen next. So if you're walking along and you see that a large truck is approaching you, you might want to predict where that truck will be in 5 seconds so that you can, you know, run away from it. So music kind of plays around with this aspect of our brain, which is, I think, very critical. It's trying to figure out the patterns that are going on. So it's kind of like music is really perfect for what our brain is really good at, which is taking in information and coming up with predictions about what's coming up next. And when you hit the right predictions, that's highly rewarding, and that's when the reward centers get active.